Welcome back to the Shtick. We've just seen a little excerpt from the opening of the, what's the exhibition called?
The Jews of Greece.
The Jews of Greece. And we have now found ourselves in the midst of Passover, better known amongst us as Pesach.
Pesach.
And the...
Hag Pesach Sameach for everyone.
Hag Pesach Sameach. We're going to say that at the end.
But okay. Sorry that I jumped in.
A bit premature.
But
what we want to talk about is the real movement of the people, the exodus of the Jewish people out of Spain. They were expelled from Spain in 1492-ish. And a lot of them went to Greece.
Yeah, I think that is what is so fascinating about the whole history of the Greek Jews, that during those times when the Inquisition and amidst the expulsion, that there was this Sultan, the Sultan of Saloniki, who said, got this idea, they're like, why are they getting rid of all this amazing, you know, community? So he just said, I'm going to create the community here. So he said, wrote a letter to the King of Spain, send it to me, and then we'll create history. And that history was created because that's where all of these, like, the merchants of the world started to emanate, hence all these kind of, like, shipping magnets coming from that kind of, like, ancestry and generation, and the whole kind of, like, hubbed up. It's just like the Hong Kong of kind of, like, the Mediterranean.
Yeah. Well, there was the Venice. Venice had the Merchant of Venice, which was a Jewish center as well. Yes. And then Thessaloniki also became, in its own right, a very strong port.
And then that was also the same time when, you know, the false messiah, Zabdai-Zvi, was part of that whole kind of thing. And then the Sultan then built this amazing kind of mosque. But it's the only mosque in the world that's decorated with Magen David.
Yeah.
So that they would be, that the community who would be attending the mosque would be feeling very comfortable, you know. So I think that is, and it still exists up to now, which is part of the whole, you know, photograph in this exhibition as well.
Yeah, we'll be seeing photos of your work. And also seeing a little bit of the opening, people wandering around because it was a wonderful opening. And we must mention the curator, Ariella Hoffman.
She did an amazing job.
The curtain effect.
Amazing job.
It really felt Mediterranean there.
Yeah, very floaty in the white. Mm. Yeah, it was beautiful.
Yeah, and it's got like this kind of, it was a very positive vessel for this exhibition, because the whole kind of like connotation of the whole history of the Jewish migration to Greece was quite dark, and then with all this feeling of white everywhere, that feels like this elevation and emanation of, you know, spirit, and people who went there said, oh, it's very positive, it's beautiful, and like all this white, so it's just cleansing and nourishing in a way.
But also, you know, it has these curtains and you sort of walk through. And for me, I was thinking about it the other day, and it sort of represents the fact that there were all these hidden stories. These stories have all been hidden from the world. Yeah. And this exhibition reveals them as you walk through these curtains. You know, these stories become revealed.
It's also depicting of the labyrinthian kind of like atmosphere of the different villages in Greece, like the
Especially
Mykonos.
The really old
so when you
villages.
Go into this like narrow passage with all these white kind of like walls and little rooms, so you kind of peek through these windows and you see the inside of what's going on in the room. So this is like what we thought when Ariel and I were talking about how we're going to put together this, like if we could recreate that kind of feel. And I think in this, Ariel kind of like succeeded in creating that and actualizing and manifesting that idea and symbolic metaphor of what Greece is all about.
And also creating periods and eras within each section, which is really beautiful. One other thing I wanted to talk about was what the future's going to be about your work. What do you think? Where do you think it's going to go?
Well, you know, we always had the vision of doing this exhibition, so we're just
thrilled.
That's
achieved.
Yes, so
it's going through till the end of September or something.
It's quite a long one.
You've got a lot of time to get there, but get there.
And so hopefully also we wanted to get it to be a traveling exhibition that would just come from here and then go to Europe or America and all those places.
Yeah.
And where a lot of in Astoria, mainly where there's the only kind of Romaniot synagogue and where a lot of the Greek Jews kind of migrated after the Holocaust.
The other thing I wanted to mention was what Philip Daladakis talked about, was that Melbourne is the third largest Greek population outside of Athens and Thessaloniki.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And also Melbourne is the largest population of Holocaust survivors.
Yeah.
I'm not sure if it's in the world, but it's one of the largest.
One of the largest, I think, outside Israel.
Outside of Israel.
Well, I think Melbourne was built, and the Jewish community was built through the survivors, kind of like migration here, like after the war.
Yeah, I think that our connection with the Greeks has been very long, and I think that your exhibition has really consolidated that. And we also had another speaker at the beginning of the exhibition who went into a lot of detail about your
That's the Consul General, yes. Christina
Simantiraki. Christina Simantiraki.
You know all the Greek names. I can't. That's why they shorten their names.
She's just lovely, and yeah, she spoke beautifully at the beginning of the ceremony, and she did speak about the history and the close connections between the two communities.
Fantastic. Yeah. So we wanted to wish all our viewers Chag Pesach Sameach. We're right when we go to air, it's just all happening, and everyone's got to clean their houses out. Get your matzahs happening, and happy Seder.
Thank you.
Happy Seder too, and then it's I'm looking Beseder. Forward for the first and second Seder. Beseder.
Beseder.
Well over the matzah.
Yeah. And next week we'll be back with a repeat of our 400th episode, which will give us a bit of time to get into our 500th, where we're just going to talk about the previous 100 shows, which I don't know how I'm going to do it, but we'll sort of get some snippets and get maybe Zeddy Lawrence here, because he's the editor of the Jewish News and he's a very interesting, well-informed man. So it was really wonderful. Thank you so much for coming on
the
show.
Thank you for having
Good
us.
Luck with your
Henry.
Exhibition.
Thank you.
We love your work.
Yes, and again, we would like to invite you to come. If you would have the time, please, you have like 5 months.
Yeah.
And come yes. and
Only
visit.
5 months.
Yes. Only 5 months. Yes.
But don't miss it.
Don't miss it.
See you next week with more Shtick. Song, food, and stories, you just can't desist. The power of a tradition no mere mortal can resist. Born